my blood. That's my blood. It's a lot of my blood. Thank you. Buy me a drink, sailor.
Harry Flynn? Hey! What the hell are you doing here?
I'm looking for you, mate.
Uh-oh. Should I be flattered or worried?
Maybe a bit of both. Come here. I've got a job for us.
Really?
A client is willing to part with a huge sum of cash if we acquire a certain object for him.
All right, I'm listening.
Now, you're not gonna like this.
Oh, no. No, you're out of your mind.
Yeah, you just hear me out for a second.
Flynn, we both know two people who were killed trying to lift something out of this place.
And one who made it out.
Yeah, barely.
I can't do this without you, Drake. You're the only one who's cracked it, and you know better than anyone it's a two-person job.
No. Three, actually.
Right. And speak of the devil, here she comes now.
What? Chloe Fraser.
Nate. Drake. Nathan. Drake.
Hello, Harry.
Chloe here's one of the best drivers in the business. She'll take good care of us.
I bet.
Right, look. I've got it all figured out. We go in through the sewer.
I'm loving it so far.
That puts us in the courtyard. From there, we scale up the wall, run across the rooftops, and just drop down into the exhibit hall. Bob's your uncle. And what is worth all this trouble, I hear you ask?
I didn't, but go ahead. But that's it. An oil lamp.
Yeah.
It's worthless. I don't get it.
Neither do we. That's why we tracked you down.
Well, it sounds like you're working for a nutcase. Some collector who's got too much time and money on his hands. And by the way, this is not worth any of it.
But there's more. How's your 13th century Latin, mate?
Where'd you get this?
Borrowed it from the files of the nutcase.
In Trebizond, we were set upon by thieves. Father, Maffeo, and I were robbed of our greatest treasures. This was written by Marco Polo.
Yes, that much we were able to work out.
Unfortunately, the rest of it's nonsense.
Hey, hold on. So that it should not fall into the wrong hands, I concealed my great sorrow in the unlikeliest place. The light of the great Khan shelters the fate of the 13.
See what I mean? It's just gibberish.
He's talking about the lost fleet.
Yeah.
I know. Someone want to fill me in?
Marco Polo leaves China with 600 passengers and 14 ships loaded down with treasure from Kublai Khan. And he lands in Persia a year and a half later with only one ship left and only 18 passengers. Now, he recorded every detail of his journey, but he never told what happened to all those ships and the passengers.
So somewhere out there are 13 ships loaded with the Emperor's treasure waiting to be found.
Yeah, and that is what your client is after. Hey, look at this lamp. It's covered in Mongolian script. It must have been a gift from Kublai Khan.
The light of the great Khan shelters the fate of the 13.
Marco Polo hid something inside this lamp. Something that pinpoints the site of the lost fleet.
So, we're dicking this guy over, right?
Damn straight.
Absolutely. You in then?
What the hell? I mean, what could possibly go wrong?
Thank you. wheat.
Of course it's locked. It's always locked. Karma's a bitch.
Thank you.
Hello. Well, so much for foreplay.
You mind telling me what the hell is going on?
You mean with Flynn?
Yeah, you might have warned me.
And missed the look on your face? Anyway, you haven't exactly made yourself easy to find.
Talk about making yourself easy.
Oh, you're not jealous. Let's not forget who walked out on whom. After all, you don't get to be jealous.
Wait a minute, Chloe.
If it makes you feel any better, my relationship with Flynn is strictly professional.
Really?
Mostly professional.
Oh.
When I figured out he was actually on to something, I thought you'd want to be in on the action.
So what's the plan?
Just like we said, we pull the heist, we find the ships, and we make off with the treasure.
With Flynn?
Mm-hmm.
And then?
And then we split the take three ways, and you and I just disappear. Together, this time.
I see.
Until then, he can't know about us.
He's gonna be pissed.
He's gonna be fine. Trust me.
Sure you're up for this? Feel a lot better if I had a gun. We won't need them. A little insurance, that's all.
Flynn, they're just museum guards. And we have their patrols all mapped out. Relax.
Relax? Relax. Have you ever been in a Turkish prison, mate? If we get caught, they will lock us up and throw away the sodding key. You do realize that, don't you?
Better than you do.
Well, you may fancy that kind of thing, but I don't. Can't afford to make any mistakes.
Yeah, and we won't.
We're here.
This way.
So what do we do if they switch the patrols?
Figure it out as we go.
We cannot fumble our way through this.
I don't fumble. I improvise.
Oh, is that what you call it?
Yeah. I'm, adaptable.
Adaptable?
You cocky bastard.
There. What did I tell you? That passage there is going to take us right under the museum.
You called it, all right.
You need to have a little more faith in me, chum.
Okay. This one here is me.
All right, remember, that tower's our only way into the exhibit. But we can't even get close with those floodlights on.
We've gone over this.
Just make sure you cut the power by the time we reach the second courtyard.
The lights will be out. I'll have the van waiting at the rendezvous point. Just make sure you get your asses out of there in time.
Fair enough.
Let's do this.
Chloe. See you on the other side.
Looking forward to it.
You sure you know where you're going?
Don't I always?